Hey guys, and welcome to the channel. Today we are going to be talking about trying to fix any issues you have with filtration in your beer. So today we are in Tux in Nottingham. We're joined here by Derrick from Murphy & Son. Derrick, welcome, and
thanks.
Tell us a bit about yourself.
So my name's Derrick Orford. I qualified as a master brewer in 1991.
Okay.
I've brewed all over the world, but now I'm helping other brewers through Murphy's.
All right, great stuff. And we are talking about trying to sort out issues that you're going to have with filtration in your beer through enzymes?
Yeah, exactly. And of course, normal problems with beer filterability are to do with solids hitting the filter. But in this case, you've got beer that looks pretty clear, actually.
Yeah.
But it's still gumming up your filter, and that's confusing you, and you're wondering what to do.
Okay. And you're utilizing enzymes to fix the filter problems that you're having?
Yeah, that's correct. Okay. So enzymes are very simple proteins that convert or help convert one thing into another.
Okay.
So a common enzyme would be in our saliva, which is starting to convert starch
into sugar,
into the digestion process.
Right.
So these are doing a similar thing in different ways.
Yeah. I know that word enzyme gets thrown away all over in the brewing process, and I don't know if everybody actually knows what an enzyme is, but I think that's a good, it's a sort of converting, or it's...
Yeah, or imagine a lock that you're trying to open, and the enzyme is the key that's going to open that lock for you.
Okay, all right, that makes perfect sense now. and then to do with filtration, I know this is a way to improve your filtration. Will this work on any sort of filtration system, so plate filters, or, you know, pretty much, so it's going to cover most filtration issues?
It will cover any types of filtration.
Okay.
So whether you're using pads or using Kieselguhr, or you've got a cartridge filter, if your filters are gumming up, this is one way to find out how to stop them gumming up.
So if somebody is having a problem of just filter gumming up, this is the kind of first step that you want to take.
Yeah, so there's probably going to be an enzyme that's going to solve your problem.
Okay.
But to determine which enzyme is going to do that, you'll need to do some testing. Or Murphy's can do that testing for you.
Okay. And then with regards to the products that we're going to use today, I know we were speaking about it briefly. Just give us a quick overview on the different products.
Yeah, so probably three main products that are going to be most useful here.
Yeah.
So the first one is beta-glucanase.
Okay.
So that's an enzyme that breaks down beta-glucans that are present in the cell walls of the barley corn.
Okay.
The second one is tryzyme. Tryzyme is a blend of three different enzymes.
Okay.
So it's a bit like throwing everything at the issue.
Yeah.
So that's the beta-glucanase as well, but it's also got a proteinase to break down protein, an alpha amylase to break down certain parts of large sugar molecules.
Okay.
And then the third one we'll look at is AMG, amyloglucosidase.
Okay.
And again, that's breaking down most starch type molecules into small sugar molecules.
Okay. And I know you said there was a fourth one, the pineapple enzyme, but that's not really used for this.
Yeah, so that's papain.
Okay.
It's got a kind of code name, NDB3.
Okay.
And that will break down certain types of protein. But I think the first three of what we've talked about are probably going to solve the issue.
Okay. So awesome, Paul. Let's go do some testing on some beers that we got from Tux and see how it's all done.
Let's do it.
All right, perfect. So Derrick, got our setup here. I know obviously we with the actual chemicals that we're going to be using, or the enzymes that we're going to be using, we've got them in smaller batches. Obviously you're going to have them in a lot larger batches from Murphy's. And just give us a quick overview on the equipment that you need to do this.
Sure, yeah. So you're going to need a filter funnel with some filter papers. Doesn't have to be a fancy conical flask, anything, a jug will do. And a jug with the beer that you want to process. And you're going to do a few runs, so you're going to need a few jugs of beer. And then to dose the enzymes in, I've got quite a fancy pipette, but again, it doesn't have to be as fancy as this. The one that you used to use at school, the glass one, is also pretty good. But if you've got one of these, even better.
So is it the pipette side of things, is that just to make sure you're getting the correct sort of measurements on?
Yeah, everything? So you want the test to be reflective and add the same amount of enzymes to the sample, and then you can compare how each one's performing.
Okay, all right, great stuff. Let's get into it then.
Okay, so the detailed instructions are on a sheet like this, so you can refer to that. I'm not going to go through the exact detail, but what you'll have done previous to the enzyme sample is that you've put a sample of untreated beer through your filter paper, and you'll have measured how long it takes to filter a certain amount of beer. So let's say you've got a constant amount of beer to start with, and you're measuring the time it takes to filter. And it will filter fairly slowly because this is your problem beer. Then what you're going to do is take a sample. So we've got beta-glucanase here as an example. Following the instructions on that sheet I just showed you, you're going to take a defined volume of the enzyme. You're going to add that to the beer. Give it a little bit of a swirl to mix it. And then simply you're going to pour it into the filter paper. And again, that's going to filter over a period of time. And hopefully, if beta-glucanase is going to be your solution, it's going to filter faster this time. And that's going to be an indication that beta-glucanase is the right enzyme to use. And then you do exactly the same thing for each of the enzyme samples.
Okay.
So you're doing that for your NDB3, your papain enzyme, the trizyme, and the AMG.
Okay. And you're saying, obviously, you're going to need to time this. So this is going to be a case of, okay, let's pour it in and then have it like a stopwatch next to it. And
yeah, exactly. Just use the stopwatch on your phone.
Okay.
And measure away.
Okay. And use and the amount of beer, is that just a preference of if you want to just do 100 mils?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. You'll get a feel if you use a 500 mils of beer and it takes hours to go through, then obviously
there's a problem.
Use a bit less.
All right, no, great. And the filter paper, is it specific filter paper that you were using here, or
it's a classic Wattman filter paper, but okay. If you've got coffee filter papers at home, you could use those as well.
And if you're trying to replicate the different machinery that you've got, like plate filters and that, so this is all going to work for
this covers the basics.
Okay, yeah. All right, no, great stuff. So there you go, guys. If you're trying to optimize your brewing and trying to sort out an issue on filtration in your brew house, this is the way to do it. Get yourself any of these products, give us a shout. If there's any more problems, you can give Murphy's a shout. We'll be able to help you out. Thanks, guys. Happy brewing.